So for about a week now, my friend Benjamin and I have been watching two movies from the Saw franchise a day, and it's been a good old time. These movies are really strangely addicting, even though they're kind of repetitive, and they're not exactly the deepest movie, but it's something you just can't stop watching once you start. Now maybe I'm a mindless sheep that enjoys shitty movies made for the masses, or maybe I have a massive, ginormous, pulsating brain, and I truly appreciate fine art. But I really enjoy these movies, so I thought I'd try and make some videos on them. I don't want to call this video a review, it's just my thoughts on a dumb video, so please don't hurt me. If you disagree with my opinions, just hit the upside down thumbs down button to let me know. There were some things I didn't like about Saw, but overall it was pretty good. It's a very fun movie to just watch with your brain switched off. It's mindless fun and there's something super infectious about these movies.
Oh, what a big tootsie.
Watching the different characters go through rooms, trying to solve the way out and having to go through horrible pain to get to the next one is always really fun. But that's not how it is in the first movie, and I think I prefer it this way. Two dudes changing some poles with clues scattered throughout one room, having conversations and trying to figure out how they got there was really enjoyable to watch. I also think the main characters, Adam and Lawrence, have a good dynamic. Like, their dialogue and delivery is always good, even when it's not very good at all.
You have to die.
No, I want to live!
I'm sorry.
I want to live!
My family.
Every scene spent in the bathroom with these two is like the best parts of the movie. I could have watched a whole movie of just that. And overall, yeah, I did like the Saw movie, but I do have a lot of things that I didn't like about it. And now that I've told you how much I like the movie and the franchise, I'm about to rag on the first movie for the rest of this video. So as someone who has never seen any movie out of the Saw franchise until this week, I was expecting like an overly brutal escape room type situation for the whole movie. As well as the classic of forcing characters to go through horrible pain to open a door and whatnot. And that is a part of the franchise, but a huge portion of these movies is spent following the narrative of the Jigsaw Killer himself and the police and detectives trying to stop him. But that's something I came to expect after the second movie, and going into the rest of them, I enjoyed those sections of the movies for the most part. But after seeing the whole series and going back to look at the first one, it really wasn't as good as most of the others. The pacing seemed off, and a lot of the movies is spent focused on stuff I just didn't have a reason to care about. I just couldn't get invested in Detective Tapp's story or Lawrence's life outside of the decrepit, dank bathroom. When you get to the end of the movie, it does end up seeming pretty significant for the twist at the end and watching it all come together. But even still, do we really need to dive into Tapp's story? It didn't seem to tie too strongly to everything else, other than when Detective Tapp interrogated Lawrence. And like I said before, these were parts I liked in the later movies. But in this one, none of the other plot lines seemed necessary to move the story along and for it all to come together. I would have much preferred to watch Adam and Lawrence dick around in that room and see some cool puzzles, or watch Adam stick his arm down some more toilets than try to care about Tapp's story and watch him creep about trying to avenge the headless horseman over here. And one of the biggest problems I have with this movie, and specifically the first Saw movie, even though it's a running theme in the series, is how long we've spent outside of the room Jigsaw has set up for Adam and Lawrence. After getting into the second movie, I got invested in the story of all these characters and how they all connected, but here I didn't really feel that connection. Over half the movie is spent following other people, when the best parts were when we were just listening to Adam and Lawrence talk and find clues to figure out how to get out. We spend so much time seeing how Adam and Lawrence got in this situation and watching Tapp avenge his partner, which always seemed to just make the movie go slower, when we could have spent that time seeing more cool shit from Adam and Lawrence. Like this? Cool. This? Cool. This? No, come on, underarm, dude. No, man, come on, just underarm it. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, see that? Cool. But this? Boring. Okay, I've spent enough time complaining now. I'm gonna actually talk about how I like the movie overall. Despite me talking trash on this movie, there really is something super infectious about this franchise. The movie can be hot garbage, but as soon as you get to the twist at the end, goddamn, it makes you forget about the rest of the movie. They're always so damn good. And this first movie is no exception. Every part spent in the bathroom and the twist at the end make up for everything else I didn't like about it. And my god, the twist at the end of this movie is a good one. Watching it for the first time and finding out Zepp, or Budget Tom Kenny as I like to call him, wasn't the Jigsaw Killer, and that the actual killer, John, who we saw earlier on in the film, was lying in that room alive the whole time. Holy shit, it's good. It's good until the very, very end when John shuts the door on Adam. Adam.
But not you.
My boy Adam.
Not anymore. Game over.
You know what? Scrap everything I've said up until this point. Adam is the best part of this movie and he saves it all.
I'm having a blast. This is the most fun I've had without lubricant.
We stand Adam around these parts. My man is smart, he's handsome, he's funny, and he did nothing wrong to deserve being in this situation. Jigsaw's reason for putting him here is that he lives a boring life. What kind of a reason is that? Most of these people he captures are drug addicts, they're unfaithful, they're suicidal, or whatever else. But no, my main man Adam, he lived a boring life. He doesn't deserve this shit. And not only is he an amazing man who did nothing wrong, but he also saves Lawrence's ungrateful, cheating ass at the end of the movie, right after being shot by him. I am livid. And spoilers for the rest of the movies, that he dies too. We see him in the next movie as a decaying corpse. You best believe I punched a hole in my monitor after seeing that shit. I want justice for this man. It's no wonder the ratings started to drop after the first movie either. And they're not bad movies, they're really, really not. They're okay, they're good, they're fine. But clearly everyone else felt the same way I did about Adam, and that's why the ratings declined from every single movie after this one. But yeah, so, it's pretty good.